Like we always do with this time. I get to shine.
Hey everyone, welcome back. I hope you are all as excited as I am for another DIY video. I'm on a huge DIY kick, which is kind of funny because up until about 4 months ago, I had never done anything myself. I was more BUY, and now things have completely changed because I've realized once you start making things yourself, you really cherish and appreciate those items and they become a really great conversation piece. I hope you enjoy some of these things as well. I have a lot more DIY videos coming up, so definitely subscribe if you want to see those. And also, as an added bonus, I'm doing a giveaway. I'm giving away a $100 Michaels gift card, and that's just to inspire you to do some of these DIY projects or any other DIY projects that you're interested in. And to enter that giveaway, you just have to be subscribed to my channel, like this video, and leave a comment below as to which of these DIYs I'm about to show you is your favorite. And if you want bonus entries, you can follow me on Twitter and Instagram, whichever one you have. Now, I call these summer-inspired DIY room decor, but really these would look great any time of the year. I just find them summer-inspired based on the color palette, and there's a little bit of a beach theme going on, and that reminds me of the summertime. These are easy and they're inexpensive and they are also pretty darn cute. I hope you like them as much as I do. So let's get started. We're going to start by making these ribbon pillows. These are adorable and really quick and easy to make. For this, you're going to need a pillow with a case, a ribbon in the color of your choice, and scissors. First, you need to mark where you're going to make your cuts. I did about 5 inches from the top and 3 inches from the side. And once you mark the pillowcase, then you just need to make your cuts. I made about 3/4 of an inch cuts on the top and the bottom of the case. From there, you just need to cut your ribbon. You can always trim it if it's too long. Mine are about 20 inches long. And then you just put them through the holes and tie them in two bows. As you can see, this is super simple to do and adds a really cute touch to your bedroom. Up next is light curtains. This is personally my favorite and is a really simple way to turn boring windows from drab to fab. And I can't even convey how gorgeous these look in person. This video doesn't even do them justice. They give a really soft ambient lighting to your bedroom. Now all you need for this is your string lights and some tulle fabric. This is really inexpensive from any fabric store. I got about 8 yards for under $10. You can also pick up a floral garland as an accent piece, but this is totally optional. Now you start by hanging your lights from the ends of your curtain rods, and if you don't have curtain rods, it's really easy just to pick up and install hooks on the corner of your windows. From there, you then add the tulle on top, and you want to wrap the tulle around the lights. You can go back and of course fix it if you need to. And then you finish off with your floral garland, or you can also tie a pretty fabric bow on the corners that also looks really pretty. And here are the finished light curtains. I really, really love these, and I actually did them on all of the other windows in my apartment. Next are a couple of decorative room accents. The first one is an adorable mason jar candle. Now for this, you will need mason jars, floating candles, also tea candles work for this, some small rocks, and raffia. Now all you need to do for this is add your rocks to the bottom of the mason jar, add your water, and then you need to get your raffia, measure it out to get enough to tie a bow around the top rim of the mason jar. Obviously, once you're all done with that, you can cut off the excess and fluff up your bow, and then add your candles, light those, and you are left with a really cute decorative room accent. I really love the glow these leave off at night. Now another really cute, easy room accent are these shell jars. For this, all you need are some mason jars and some shells. You just fill up the mason jar with the shells, and if you have different colored shells, you just need to put on the cap and shake it all together to mix the shells together. And there you go, it's really simple, and all of these put together on top of my dresser with some flowers and a vase looks so adorable. And last is this really pretty flower wall art. using toilet paper rolls. Yep, believe it or not, that's made from toilet paper rolls. Now, what you need for this are paper towel or toilet paper rolls. If you don't have them hanging around your house, you can actually also make them using cardstock and tape. You will also need a glue gun and some spray paint, whatever color you want your flower to be, and a blank art canvas. I got a burlap one, but you can also get a white one as well. It looks equally as good. Now, if you're using toilet paper rolls, you will need about a dozen of them, and you just cut them into thirds or 1.5 inch pieces. And if not, like I said, it's very easy to make your own. Lay your cardstock down vertically and measure out 5 inches from the bottom and the top, and cut out your 5 by 8.5 inch rectangles. Then you roll up the paper and tape the edges together, which forms the petal shape or teardrop that you're going to use to make your art piece. What I like to do as I'm cutting my petal pieces is setting them on the canvas just so I can see how many I need and that it's the correct size. For this in particular piece, I needed about 40 petals. Then you need to whip out your glue gun and start assembling. First, I make the center piece of 6 petals. You can just watch here to see how I do this. And once you have your center piece created, it's really easy. All you do is just set the other pieces in the crevices between the petals, and it just comes together very naturally. This is what the finished piece looks like, and then we get to our spray painting. I actually had to do about 3 coats. You have to make sure you get inside the petals and around the edges, and then this is what it looks like when it is all done and ready to go. Once it is all dry, you then just need to use your glue gun again and glue it onto the canvas, and it is all done. This really looks so pretty and artistic, and I like to call it wall art with absolutely zero artistic ability required. So that's it for today's video. I really hope you liked it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to enter the giveaway. All of the details are in the description box. Mistakes. We all make them, some worse than others. But we're all human, and what's important is that we learn from our mistakes and don't continue making them in the future. That being said, today we're gonna talk about skincare mistakes. These are the most common skincare mistakes that you may very well be making without even realizing it.